Hello viewers, welcome to another very interesting video. In this tutorial, we will learn how three-phase induction motor works, or what is the working principle of three-phase induction motor. This is how I am going to explain the working of induction motor. First of all, I will explain how rotating magnetic field is produced by discussing the arrangement of windings in stator. Then comes a very important concept, which is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. In this, I will explain how electric current is induced in rotor of induction motor. After the induction, how magnetic field applies force on rotor to rotate according to Fleming left-hand rule. And finally, I will explain what happens after the rotor or induction motor starts to accelerate. So please stick till the end of the video to better understand all about induction motor. The stator of induction is a stationary part which contains three sets of windings, labeled as AA, BB and CC, which are geometrically spaced 120 degrees apart. When these windings are energized by three-phase supply, the currents produced in these windings are also spaced by 120 degrees, as you can see in this diagram. After the current in the stator is produced, let's see how flux distribution in the motor looks like. The coils are arranged such that the flux distribution generated by any one winding is approximately sinusoidal. Since the coils are spaced 120 degrees apart, the flux distribution is the sum of the fluxes of all three windings' flux. Therefore, the net flux in three-phase motor is constantly rotating vector with constant amplitude. Now we understand how rotating magnetic field is produced. Now it's time to discuss the most important phenomena, which is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which states that whenever a conductor is placed in a changing or rotating magnetic field, an electromotive force is induced. If the conductor circuit is closed, a current is induced. Similar phenomena happens in induction motor. Initially, the rotor is stationary. The moment the stator supply is switched on, currents start to flow and the rotating magnetic field is established. As the rotor consists of conductors which are shorted together, EMF is induced which causes current to flow in the rotor windings. Once the current established in rotor conductors now applies another property of magnetic field, which states that a current-carrying conductor when placed in magnetic field experiences a force which moves the conductor. The direction of force is given by Fleming left-hand rule. These current induced in rotor creates its own magnetic fields, which interact with the rotating stator field to produce forces on the individual rotor conductors, and a net rotor torque causes the rotor to rotate. The rotor starts to accelerate, lowering the relative speed between the rotating field and rotor conductors. This is called rotor slip, which is the difference between speed of rotating field and rotor conductors. As the relative motion or slip is reduced, the induced EMF, conductor currents, and subsidiary magnetic fields are also reduced. The rotor continues to accelerate until the electrical torque exactly equals the mechanical load torque on the shaft. At this point, the rotor is running at a speed slightly slower than the rotating field. I hope you clearly understand the working principle of three-phase induction motor. For more interesting videos, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.